emotional. Of course, more good than bad. I mean, you know, it's tough, you know, coming into a place, you know, for 1 year. But, I mean, this city's been nothing but great to, you know, Trey and myself. You know, it's coming to here being, you know, 1 year guys, being done in one guys. Coming to here, you know, this city's just been amazing to us. So definitely going to be a lot of emotion, range of emotion. But still, you know, eventually have to go out there and play the game.
What's been like the last couple of weeks, knowing this was coming? Just how are you dealing with it? Do you get your arms around it, or is it just sort of weird?
Well, I mean, the past couple of weeks, I've really just tried to soak up each day. You know, just take it day by day. You know, can't get too high and can't get too low, you know, whether the wins or the losses. But, you know, just have to try to stay even keeled throughout this whole process. You know, it's funny to say that this is my last my second to last college game ever. So, you know, growing up with my friends, you know, I was always the youngest one, you know, the last one to get to college. And now I'm the last one to leave. So it's definitely, you know, exciting. Just looking forward to tomorrow.
Well, even as your keel bent in the last few weeks?
You guys have seen it. You know, it's been, you know, pretty much the same. You know, after a win, of course, you know, there's more laughs. But after a loss, you know, it's more serious, you know. Just having to understand that, you know, in this game of basketball, you know, it really teaches you a lot about your character and about how you can handle certain situations. So whether it may be, you know, us hearing about the postseason ban or, you know, getting a win, getting a loss, you know, you can sort of channel that and change that to, you know, real life instances, you know. a win could be sort of like, you know, getting a good grade in a class. You know, you understand that you worked hard to get that grade, but you can't be satisfied with that because there's other classes that you still have to take.
Can you assess the competition that you faced this year compared to last year? And has it been significantly different, or maybe not as much as you thought, however it's been?
It has. It's been, you know, a lot different. I mean, the CAA is, you know, a great conference, but, you know, understanding that coming from, you know, the CAA, which is a pretty good mid-major conference, to playing in, you know, the best conference in the country, is definitely a big jump. You know, and I think that the jump mainly consists of with scouting. I think scouting in the ACC is, you know, bar none. I feel like it's, you know, this is the best conference, but I feel that my game has translated well, you know, over the past couple of months.
You're a guy who, you know, you tell the story about going to Madison Square Garden when you're a little kid and being on the floor and coming back there. You go to Cameron Indoor, some of these places. How much has that come up in your mind when you walk out onto these famous floors in the conference that you've been playing?
Of course, you know, it's there. Well, the main goal is to try to go in there and try to, you know, win the game. But, you know, I definitely have to give thanks to Coach for, you know, allowing me the chance to be here and play. You know, I never would have got the chance to play at Breslin Center, Michigan State, at Duke, at Kentucky, at Notre Dame. And these are gyms that, and coliseums that, you know, my friends have all played in. I've had a lot of friends that played in the ACC. So they've all been able to play, you know, at these wonderful arenas and, you know, at these venues. And finally to, you know, for it to come full circle and me to be actually able to play and get that experience, I think that it's just amazing.
What's next for you? What do you think?
Well, spring break. No, I mean, of course, you know, focusing on these next two games. But, you know, after this, you know, just give my body and mind some time, you know, rest a little bit. But, of course, I can't take too much time. You know, starting to get ready for the draft process, you know, whatever that may be. You know, but it's really just starting to, you know, prepare myself as a pro and just get ready for the next level, wherever that is.
What are some of your assets you think that would make you fit with the right NBA team?
I would say IQ, knowing the game. And then, of course, you know, some of the obvious, you know, shooting, you know, defensive abilities. You know, I feel like I can guard my position at the next level. But definitely just, you know, IQ, and then also some, you know, I feel like that when it comes down to testing, that I'll be able to test, you know, well enough with, you know, whether it may be at the combine or, you know, at pro days.
Have you been invited, like, Portsmouth or the NAB
All-Star game? Right? I actually haven't even spoken to anyone about that stuff. You know, my main focus, you know, ever since the beginning of the year has been, what can I do to try to help this team win? So once the season ends, then, you know, I'll start to transfer my thoughts more towards, no pun intended, but transfer my thoughts more towards, you know, that next level.
Those guys are coming behind.
Coach has said that, he's told us a story about you sending him the text, you know, that even with all that's happened, I would still come here. So what are the different factors that have made this such a great experience? That even with, I mean, this is a pretty traumatic thing to hit you, that it's been a positive experience for you still.
I think just the people here, you know, have been so supportive, you know, ever since day one, ever since I committed, you know, last year. You know, everyone said that this is a very, very special place, and, you know, I definitely have not taken it for granted, you know, one bit. You know, ever since I've gotten here, everyone's just been so supportive of me and this team, and a real goal of, you know, myself to come here was, you know, I had two main things. One was to put myself in a position to try to win a national championship with the roster that we have. All right, we can't do that. It's fine. I'm not complaining. Things happen in life. Another thing was to be a part of a family. And I think that that's one thing that I've done successfully is, you know, sort of, you know, bridge this team together a little bit, you know, not just myself, but with the character that we have with the other 14 guys that I suit up with every day.
A lot of guys have been coming behind you with this fifth-year graduate transfer deal, and there is a concerted effort to make it go away, to eliminate that possibility. Have lived it, what has it been like for you, and what would you say to those people who try to take away that opportunity?
I mean, I'm a prime example. You know, someone who, you know, took that jump and, you know, had that fifth year and took the opportunity. And my main thing when I said that I was leaving Drexel was, well, actually, one of my coaches actually told me this. He said, no matter what you do in life, if you feel comfortable and you have an opportunity to make yourself better, and if you feel there's something that can help your family, then go do it. Just make sure that you're comfortable and you believe in your decision 100%. And that's exactly what I did, and I wouldn't be standing here today if I wasn't confident in myself and comfortable knowing what, you know, what I could bring on the court. But that's nonetheless, it's just the type of person that I've been and that I've grown into over the past couple years.
For those who would take it away, what, to the NCAA people who would think about that, what would you say to them about keeping it?
Why should you take it away? Because if a coach can leave a program and leave their players behind and go and further their career and make it better for them, why couldn't a student athlete who has the same ability that they've had at their last program and try to make themselves better, put them in a better situation for their family, and they already have a degree? So the object of getting to college, playing basketball, being on scholarship, is to graduate. That's the only objective that you have as a student athlete and that you want to accomplish is to graduate.
How do you think this team should be remembered?
I mean, you know, great group of guys. I really feel that this team is really special. Be remembered, I mean, like, just throw basketball just out the window. This team is probably the best group of guys that I've been around as a collective unit, you know, and I mean, I've been in college for 17 years, so I've done seen it all. So, no, but seriously, you know, this group of guys, it's just amazing. And it's, you know, I've said it once before and I'll say it again. If you see one of us, you see four or five of us. And that's rare. I mean, of course, you don't really see that at the pro level. But even, you know, being on college teams and seeing college teams, if, you know, there's some cliques here and there with this team, there's no cliques. It's literally 1 through 15. We could all be hanging out playing video games together, be in three different rooms playing three different systems. And it's just, you know, we just try to enjoy as much time as we can together.
You think that Dang could be the best player in college basketball eventually. That doesn't look that far-fetched now after what we've seen the last couple weeks. How good can this be with Dang and with Donovan and all the guys returning? They could be pretty special, don't you?
Yeah, shoot, I wish I had another year. I'll tell you that much. Can we work on that? Give me a 6 year. No, but this team is definitely going to be amazing next year with, you know, all the talent that's coming back. You know, Quentin, I mean, I can go down the list. Quentin's going to be amazing. I feel that he's really, really underrated and that a lot of people don't talk too much about him. But if you watch how Q plays, he controls the game from the complete point guard standpoint. But, you know, referring back to Dang, I mean, with him, Ray and Donovan all getting another year under their belt, them getting better, I'd say probably the last 2 weeks in practice, Motz has been dominant. And, you know, if you guys could see that, Motz has grown, Motz is getting better. Of course, Nanu's getting better. And, I mean, this team next year, I really think that they can make, you know, a lot of noise. And then, of course, with Mango and Anas coming back as well, so.
Some discussion that what happened to this team shouldn't happen to other teams in the future. What would be your recommendation to the NCAA about how these kind of cases should be handled?
I mean, that's not really something that I can comment on. You know, I can't, you know, necessarily comment on the future. I can only comment on what's, you know, regarding right now. I mean, does it suck? Yeah. I'd be lying if I said it didn't, but it's one of those things where, you know, you just have to roll with the punches. You know, things happen in life, and sometimes, you know, people that aren't involved have to pay for it. But, I mean, we're all mature, and I feel like that this is something that's helped us, you know, come together as a team and grow as individuals and, you know, as a complete unit. I mean, this is something that doesn't, I mean, of course, it affects our basketball life, but in time, basketball is going to end, and the ball is going to stop bouncing. So this is something that we can eventually all look back on and just think like, all right, this is something that we've learned from and that, you know, we can all grow and, you know, can just make us better people.
David, you knew this was a passionate fan base. Were you ever kind of blown away, you and Trey, by the support you've gotten during your time here?
Yeah. Just, you know, just people just coming up. It was actually when, like, I first got here, you know, people were like, oh, hey, Damion, what's up? And then I think it was after the Duke game last week, I went to the mall with my mom. And she was like, all right, come on, let's just go to the mall. I was like, Ma, I really don't think that's a good idea. She was like, no, look, it's fine. We'll just go to the mall. I just got to run in this store. You can do this, and then we'll just meet back. I said, Mom, I really don't think that's a good idea. She said, all right. So as soon as we walk in the mall, I said, all right, Mom, let's have a little bet. Said, I'll buy dinner for you if less than 20 people ask for, you know, a picture or autograph. She was like, all right, fine. It was probably like, we were probably there for like 15 minutes. I think at least 30 people came up and stopped me. And it was literally like an assembly line. It was like, hi, nice to meet you. I'm Damion Lee. And we're just taking pictures down the line. But, I mean, that's something that, you know, I would have never even had the chance to get if I didn't even come here. And just this fan base is just amazing, just been completely supportive throughout, you know, my first day being here. And I know tomorrow I feel like my ears are probably going to be ringing the whole game with a lot of cheers from senior night.
So Mom bought dinner, is that what you're saying?
Yes, she did. She had to.
The fan supports, like the sympathy for you and Trey has just been a little too much, like overblown a little bit or not? No,
not at all. I mean, knowing that this fan base really cares about, you know, Louisville basketball. I mean, we are the pro team here. I don't really think that it's been sympathy. I feel that it's more passion and that they care about the team and the school and the program so much. So they want to give, you know, their best efforts to try to always be there for us. And I definitely feel like, you know, 10, 15 years down the road when, you know, my career is over, I can definitely come back here. And, you know, this is a place that I can call home.
Damion, you mentioned, you know, throughout this whole process, you just got to roll with the punches. Has it been difficult to sometimes roll with the punches?
Of course. I mean, what boxer doesn't, you know, want to get hit? I mean, what boxer wants to get hit, you know? So it's one of those things where, you know, you just have to make sure, in a sense, you know, keep your guard up. You know, you just don't let anybody that's, you know, spewing any type of hatred towards you, you just deflect it all off, and all the negative, you just let it, you know, rinse off you. And then, you know, you just, you know who's really there in your corner. And not to make this into a boxing analogy, but you really know who's there that's, you know, in your corner. So it's just, you know, something that, you know, I mean, I'm truthfully just, to be honest, I'm just grateful just to be in this position. Having, you know, two major injuries over the past couple years, you know, after tearing my ACL almost 3 years ago, I questioned why. You know, I had no idea why. And, you know, just knowing that God always has a plan for something. Coming back after a torn ACL last year, playing the season that I had, then breaking my hand with 3 games to go. Another question, I questioned why. And then, you know, I just had to take a step back and then just realized that, you know, maybe it was time for me to go. And, I mean, this place, you know, accepted me with open arms, and like I said before, there's no other place I'd rather go.
I was just curious, like, where were you? How many people recognize you in the mall in Philly if you ever go?
In Philly?
Yes, wearing Drexel gear.
Actually, a couple people knew me in Drexel because there was like a billboard that was like right by 30th Street Station. So every time, you know, I walk around in Drexel, they would notice me. But outside of like West Philly, nah, I'd probably say like two people.
One more of that thing. Where was the dinner?
Buffalo Wild Wings. And actually, the funny thing is, our waiter, and it was right after the Duke game. So our waiter comes up and he was like, hey man, he was like, do you like Louisville basketball? I was like, they're all right, you know, no big deal. So he starts walking to the back. And it's probably like 30 minutes after we get our food. He comes up. He was like, oh, I just seen you on TV. Good game today, man. Good game. And then, at least he didn't, you know, recognize and didn't.
All right, thanks, Nate.
Yep. All right. Thank you.